Hi, hola, and hello. I'm Hansi Herzog. Welcome to Co-Create. Our vision is to unite the world community so we're able to co-create a good life for all. Therefore, we invite you to become part of the world's largest co-creation partnership. So to explain more what this means and to get in contact with you, our community, we decided to start the 30 days video challenge. So welcome on day 21. We are in the fourth week. It's Wednesday, and Wednesday is always co-create in action. So with co-create in action, we want to explain with the model how the model would work in different cases. So let's jump directly into, if you know this already, I'm sharing my screen and jump to my graphic device. You will see me not or very few in the corner, and I'm switching to my wonderful board here. So the first time we took a look on how a cooperative would grow in the ecosystem and with which purpose. Then we had a look on the very specific use case of child care, or Sename, how it's called in Chile. And last time we had a look in on how would the model works in regions. So today, for the last video in this series, we will have a look on the global scale. So how would the world's largest co-creation partnership start and work? And this is for the reason, because it's a very huge topic for us now. If the situation with Corona, that so many people feel disconnected, is actually a good situation and good moment to start. But yeah, let's find it out. Let's jump into it. Welcome to Co-Create, the Global Solution Ecosystem. On one of the last videos, you got to know already our four process steps: collecting, networking, co-creation, and self-organization, where we start with the collection of best practice, resources, experts, partners, products, and so on, to guide them through this process of deeper connection. Each of that takes place in all of our different parts of our model. This is the structure model, the core of the ecosystem approach, where you see divided different resources and topic actors of change makers, and we'll come to that later. And the last time you also got to know our backbone model with different regions. We took a look at the neighborhood. Let's have a look if I can, not yet. Now I can paint on it, right? On a neighborhood, and today we will take a look on the global level. All levels in between would work very, region, not the neighborhood, would work very similar with some soft changes, but it's really important to act on all levels, because change happens on all levels and have different requirements and law structures and actors of each levels. So the last time, very few short, you also got to know the Holland principle. Means that, of course, it's not like a hierarchy with the region and the global level, but they're a part of each other. So a lot of small neighborhoods make together. Dun, 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 when it doesn't work. A lot of small. Dun, dun, dun. Okay, let's leave that. I think you got it. Small neighborhoods make together regions. A lot of regions make together than a nation state, and so on. So let's go back to our model, where we now will start to paint. So in the middle, in the center, we have our philosophy, our purpose. It's the center of our acting. We call it a good life for all. You might call it another way, but if you really feel inside, I think the things which are connecting us as change makers are much bigger than different words we choose to say different things. So everything starts in the center. Therefore, we just give this small frame of a good life for all with regard to the three level of sustainability: environment, economics, and social. We also refer to the S17 Sustainable Development Goals you see here, human rights and so on. But what would actually happen during the world's largest co-creation partnership is that each of these elements, so the philosophy, the model, the node, different infrastructure, different topics, would become a co-create challenge. So the co-create challenge is like in the platform, which we will start then, even if it's very simple yet, it will be like a challenge where people can add and collect. And add and collect can be knowledge, more or less ideas, knowledge, people, can be resource and so on to create all these things. So on the philosophy side, we would bring people together who really focus on the on this topic to describe what is a good life for all, how we can describe it, how can we feel it, like also in romance, in philosophy writings, how we can discuss this. Yeah, that's for that. And the second level is the model. Very, very clear is what I'm presenting here. It's the co-create ecosystem model, and it's not the only model for systemic change in the world. So what we really want to do is to build a community of communities. There was one time in the discussion the question, who integrates the integrator? So we really want to bring together different people working on different models, so we can bring them together. And it's, for me, it's often like a mosaic or a puzzle, because all of them, mainly all of them shows to different points in the change process. So by bringing them together, we can really create a full picture. So next level is the node. On level of the node, we take a look on organizations and connect them who focus explicitly on networking without restrictions. So it's about networking without a specific focus. It's organization, and that's sometimes hard because in the field I experience it, most people say, yeah, they do networking. Organization, yeah, they do networking because it's part of what everybody's doing. But there are really organizations and people who do this from a professional side to network and to provide a back office. So on the level of the node, we want to bring people together, the organizations who see themselves as back office for others, so they can improve the impact. So we can, on a global level, first of all, create a global node which supports this growing ecosystem, as well as support local nodes. Like before we said, there might be the global node, maybe there are continental nodes, and there are local nodes. And these nodes already exist, like we already have impact hubs around the world, we already have Ashoka around the world, we have Greenpeace, transition towns, everything around the world in cities or villages. And all of this organization can be a node if they see themselves in this role. So, and now we come to the very, very hot level of infrastructure. So infrastructure are resources which are needed by change makers all over again. We have here communication from left to right. We have communication, media. We have knowledge management and scientific work, strategic work. We have group facilitation, community building, and so on. We have funding with IT tools. And the question mark is, because there are so much many more than I could show, but right now, most important also are spaces to meet. So I paint a little house. Yeah, that's really the part I have to practice more, the drawing, the house and the events. And that should be like a calendar, yeah, whatever. Events to meet in person, and also hubs and spaces to meet in person. So And then we come to the topics. Topics are change makers who working specifically on very concrete topics, like we have here hunger, we have healthcare, we have education, we have water access, we have electricity. Some of them are also more broad, like gender equality and peace and justice. But yeah, you find both in them. We use here as framework the 17 SDGs from the United Nations, but you can also use different frameworks. There are a lot of organizations who provide different structures for topics we have to care for, but relate to the SDGs because they're well known. And at the end, there are the public. Public are, that's very important. There are people who are not yet covered in here. Might also be people who are not really interested in change making, and also the infrastructure part and the topics and the notes, of course, in their private life, they are also part of the public, and they want to have access to food, they want to have access to healthcare, to education. And sometimes it looks obvious, especially if you live in some richer parts of the world, because you probably have all of this. The question is just in what, which quality. And if the organizations bring really all the value they can to you, and on other parts of the world, it's more obvious that there's much more to do to provide these services. So that's a general overview. Now, how it comes really into the world. I also mentioned this before. We have, right now it's called the ambassador system or the starter system. In different phases. So, and here for I switch to another color. So in phase one, we have an ambassador. What I describe here is like a standard process, how co-create can come into your life. In a ecosystem for a specific region. Here we take a look on the global region, but we explained this already in the region. So the goal is to provide a step-by-step guidance where you really can do it by your own and grow from a single person or a small group to a large ecosystem. So we start with the ambassador. In this case, it would be co-create itself. The ambassador is the one who invites. So we invite to the world's largest co-creation partnership, in this case for the global level, and the second part is the hosting team. So the hosting team is really what makes the ambassador strong. So the ambassador really kicks off the process, and now it's about finding strong partners, and we find them in the infrastructure, finding strong partners to make the next step. The next step on the local level, on the offline level, would be the co-create experience volume one. In our case, we're thinking about making an online summit for the global process. So the idea comes, I wanted to visit a conference from the United Nations regarding the 17 SDGs, and it was canceled because of Corona. And I thought, oh, so pity, but I think that there are many more organizations who and people who experience something similar, they want to meet to bring change, and it's not possible right now. So why not shifting, and this is what actually happens anyway right now, shifting more and more to the online level, especially for the global process, it's anyway this. So the idea is to have an expanded community call. We co-create, we have community calls each month or each 2 months around that. And we think about in having an expanded call during the next in the next weeks to invite people from these fields, people and organizations, because there are so many who are working already on social change, and it's all about connecting them. So in this case, we normally we would start with one person each for the first hosting meeting. In this case, we turn it around and we invite to an open call. Hope that many people are coming from different fields and bring them in own rooms during the call, so we divide the group after a while and let them discuss and let find out if they are able to define and find one person who take responsibility as a first coordinator for the further processes. And after this call, these groups, supported through the coordinator, have the task to collect further collaboration partners. And yeah, there are actually three levels. We explained this in the cooperative video. In more detail, we have the peer exchange, so they're supporting each other as peers. Then the product portfolio. It's about what can they put together to provide better and more diverse services to their audience, to the change makers. And there are the key platform elements. So these are tasks which they develop for the ecosystem itself. On the example of IT platform, they can put together their functions as a first step on the list. Just that you as changemaker, if you find one platform, from there you can find so many different functions. There are online shops around the world, there are many, many mapping tools. There are tools for self-organization, there are alternatives for Uber, and so on and so on. It's just about making it easy to access to them. That will be on that level. Of course, the same with the funds, to have a look how we can fund the process, that we don't have to always just work voluntarily and go on the edge of our resources, what I think a lot of changemakers experience. On the side of facilitation, and here is very nice example for the interconnectivity. So the facilitation is about how we can support this group process, and they send out facilitators to the different processes. So after the first hosting call, there will be one facilitator taking supporting the funds networking process, one facilitator supporting the knowledge process, one facilitator the communication, one for the notes, one for the philosophy, and so on and so on. So yeah, let's quickly explain the roles of the others. On the event level here, we are here on the online level. So it's about putting resources together to organize the online summit. And on the hub level, it might be not really functional now in Corona where we cannot meet, but in future it's very important to have real spaces where people and change makers can meet. On the level of knowledge management, and we have also here scientific work like impact measurement. The knowledge management is the most important to set up a system where we can collectively collect our knowledge from existing knowledge databases. The question is how we can bring them together, how we can develop a standard that it's in future so easy, like getting all kind of information from Wikipedia, to get really specific information for social change on this platform. And communication, of course, it's about spreading out. So when we do the online summits, to have enough invitation power to bring the people there. And also the IT is supporting here for the online summit. So, and the online summit, and we again change the column now, and the online summit is then the place where everything grows. So there will be then bigger groups of funding, bigger groups of platforms, bigger groups of facilitators, because they get invited from the hosting team. So it's this natural process of growing from one person to one group to many people. And this is then also the first time when we involve the broader scope of philosophy, model, and the topics. We will see and figure out how we define the topics, probably through the SDGs, maybe they don't work as fine, but as I mentioned before, there are a lot of other standards. Yeah, and actually what's coming afterwards, it seemed like I described in other videos already, but it's, and what you've seen in this graphic, it's collecting knowledge, resources, best practice, partners, network them, make them easy accessible on the platform, by connecting already existing platforms, bringing them into co-creation through these co-creation challenges, and then into self-organization. So having a look if they can form cooperatives together where they on a long-term base provide value. One last thing, and then we already very long with this video. On the level of the challenges, very, very important. We divide between the, yet I always say strategic and the open. So the open challenge refers mainly to the level of the topics, because there are so many different challenges we face today as society, and so many different solution approaches, that on this level it's important that it's very open. And this is something we know already from existing collaboration platforms where organizations, companies can write out challenges. What we're focusing on first are the strategic. Therefore, we're starting with infrastructure first, because that's the experience of networks. You can bring as many change makers together as you want. If they all have the same problems, they have nobody in the team who can solve these problems or challenges, like funding, like IT platforms. Therefore, we always start first with strategic, very specific setup challenges around the infrastructure and the node, to provide the bias, the basic for the change makers. Because when the open collaboration starts, then they have easy access to everything they need. That's the principle of co-create. So, yeah, that's really over 20 minutes now. I have to stop. Let's stop this sharing and let's go back to myself very quick. So I hope you liked this video. It was the longest yet. I hope you got some information out there. And it would really help us if you leave us comments. Please give us feedback. What did you understand? What did you don't understand? What do you like? What did you didn't like? What do you think we can improve in the way of thinking or presenting? And do you know similar approaches? We're really, really, really focusing, and now in our new phase of opening up and getting in contact with more other similar organizations. So please, please, please leave us a comment below. And of course, if you like this video, please leave us a thumb up and hit the bell to subscribe to our channel to stay updated through the next weeks. So today was Wednesday, tomorrow is Thursday. Tomorrow Thursday is always collaboration knowledge. Looking forward to this. And for today, I'm just wishing you a wonderful day. Let's come together to be able to co-create the reality we desire and we deserve. Wish you a great day. Bye.